Daniella's the daughter of a fire department gentleman, Vincent. He was a captain, Vincent Giammona. And on that tragic day of 9/11, her family lost her dad. Okay? We have her here to say a few words. I'm going to get out of the way and let her speak.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Daniella Giammona. 15 years ago, I lost my father, Captain Vincent Giammona, during the September 11th terrorist attacks. This tragic event left my mother, Teresa Giammona, widowed at 31 years old, with four young daughters, ranged in age from 2 to 7. I am that 2-year-old. It is very difficult for me to speak about my dad because I never had the chance to make memories with him. That is a pain that I will always live with. Though the memories are not my own, I am grateful for the stories my family and friends have shared with me. In the firehouse, my dad was known as Lieutenant Fun. He would dress up as Elvis while he did roll call. He hosted theme nights at the firehouse, like Wild West Night when he covered the floor of the firehouse with hay. My favorite story of all time about my dad is from September 7th, 2001, a few days before he died. My mom had planned to take me and my sister, Nikki, to the Brooklyn Aquarium. When my mom told my dad we were leaving, he insisted on coming with us, even though he just finished working a 24-hour shift and hadn't gone to sleep yet. He said sleep was overrated. That's just who my dad was. Nothing slowed him down from being the best fireman or the best father he could be. We spent the morning at the aquarium taking pictures, running around, and being carried by my father on his shoulders. As we were leaving the aquarium, my dad noticed the cyclone and told my mom he couldn't leave without going on. He went right up to the booth, even though they were closed, flashed his badge and said, "My 40th birthday is on Tuesday. I need to go on." Moments later, he was the only one on the roller coaster and had a big smile on his face. My dad always tells me how excited I was to see my dad on the cyclone. That ride ended up being his last birthday wish. My dad's 40th birthday was on September 11th, 2001. When the planes hit the World Trade Center, my dad was off duty. But he went into work anyway. He was a true hero. As he left for the towers, he called my mom and told her he loved her and said goodbye for the last time. The past 15 years have not been easy without my dad. My dad has missed out on everything from birthdays and communions to high school and college. Every day something happens where I wish I could tell my dad because I know how proud he would be of all of us. We always laugh and joke about how my dad would handle having four teenage daughters. We cannot change the tragedy that happened, but we can be grateful for the good things that have come from it. Answer the Call has been one of those good things. Not only do they provide financial support to our family, which has helped my mom pay for education, school supplies, and take us on much needed family vacations, but they also host and invite us to special events each year. Events like the annual baseball game, theater events, hockey games, holiday parties, and of course, my favorite tonight, the annual gala. We look forward to these events each year because they bring all the families together. Being with other kids who have lost a parent in the line of duty helps me not feel alone and provides me with a valuable support system. Answer the Call lets me know that my dad's sacrifice will never be forgotten, that my dad will never be forgotten, and that my family will never be alone. I like to share the final line of a poem that I grew up with. The poem is about how no matter where we are or what we're doing, we remember those that we lost. As long as we live, they too will live. For they are now a part of us as we remember them. Thank you for remembering my dad. Thank you for remembering me. And thank you for answering the call.
Hey girl. Good. Just stay right there for a second.
Okay.
We have a special guest here tonight. Kanika Ingram Mann, and I would like her to come to the podium. Where is she?
Oh, here you are.
How are you?
Good evening, everyone. My name is Kanika Ingram-Mann, and it's my pleasure to be here this evening. This is the first time that I'm meeting Daniella. Hello, Daniella. So, this is fitting. Answer the call. You don't know me, but I know a ton about you. And on behalf of President John Leahy from Quinnipiac University, I would like to congratulate Daniella on being our first admit for the class of 2017.
Relax a second.